Excuse me, sir.
Hey.
Can I bother you for a minute of your time?
All right.
Nice to see you again, sir. Did you change your mind about donating by any chance? We could really use your support to improve the lives of our veterans and their families.
$20 ain't no chicken feed, but sure, I can help you out.
That's very kind. What is your name, sir?
Arthur Morgan.
Your donation will be acknowledged on a founder's plaque when the building is completed. You have a great day, Mr. Morgan.
Bonsoir, monsieur.
Oh, there you are, my dear boy.
Yes, here I am.
Well, we're going to need to get you smartened up a bit.
Why?
Well, you can't play at the tables on a Lanahassee riverboat looking like this.
You can't?
Not if you want to fit in so well that no one will realize you're there to rob the place. Now, come on.
Are we still doing that?
Of course. We're going to fix you up so fine no one will notice a thing.
Hello, can I help you, gentlemen?
Yes, my friend here is in need of a new suit.
Make this gentleman look like the Duke he really is. It was the English's fault his grandfather had to emigrate.
A bitter and jealous people.
A very good choice, sir.
Profile. The heavy brow from all the...
Come on, let's get you to the barber.
Sure.
Good luck tonight, gentlemen.
Herr Strauss has scoped the whole thing out. It's quite ingenious, actually.
What is?
The action he has planned. Indeed, it's not much of an action at all. You play cards and win. And you're going to bet very big and flamboyantly while you win. And everyone's going to think you're some new money from the oil fields come to lay it on thick and drunk. All the while, Herr Strauss will be signaling you in your line of sight. When you bust the place, they'll take you upstairs to pay you off. And that is when Javier comes in, and you take whatever you want.
You don't think they might see an armed Mexican coming into the safe with me?
Sure, they might, but perhaps not. You will see.
The suspense is killing me.
Oh, don't be so jaded. We both know this is just the kind of innocent fun you thrive on.
Well, after the past couple of months, armed robbery don't seem such an innocent pastime.
No, but we, you, all of us, will be done here soon.
I hope so.
Come on.
My good man, could you smarten up my dear hick friend here? This unlikely fellow has made himself a fortune in the oil fields and learned himself not a lick of manners or gentlemanly deportment.
Well, very good, sir.
No, it's not good. Not good at all. Not if they're going to let him play big at the tables tonight. Make him look like a prince, sir.
There, very smart.
Come on, let's get to the docks.
I've arranged some transportation for us.
Hope you have a successful evening, gentlemen.
George, to the Grand Corrigan, please.
Great.
Grand Corrigan, sir.
Well, look at you. From Toad to Prince.
Yeah, this is a bit much, ain't it? The coach?
We can't whinny up there on horses like a bunch of countrified yokels. You're a brash oil man. Money to buy. Which reminds me, no shuffling and mumbling. Puff your chest out. Get outside yourself.
Yeah, all right, all right. St. Hamlet. So, who's a mark?
Is he all right, by the way, driver?
Oh, yes. Don't worry. George and I go way back. It's a man called Desmond Blythe. Made a fortune in hosiery, of all things. Likes to play fast and always keep some extra collateral in the safe upstairs.
So, if Strauss is sitting behind him, how does he know what cards I got?
He won't. But the dealer has recently become a very good friend of mine.
Another one.
Don't worry, Arthur. We're all the authors of our own good fortune. He'll make sure you get the right cards.
What could possibly go wrong?
Indeed.
And what money am I playing with?
Don't worry. That has all been arranged. Your chips will be waiting for you.
Ah, there she is. Come on.
Okay.
Arthur, leave any weaponry here. We'll search us when we get on. George, we'll collect these from you later.
Very good, sir.
Thank you, George.
Good luck, sir.
Now remember what I said, Arthur. Everyone is the author of his own good fortune.
Yes, yes. Believe me, I heard every word.
Watch Strauss, listen to the dealer, and this should be a very lucky night. There they are.
Gentlemen! How wonderful to see you. Arthur, you remember this pair of boys we met in New York?
Come on, General.
Champagne is on dear old Arthur. He's rich as can be and feeling luckier than a turkey that survived Thanksgiving.
Hello, gentlemen.
Hello, dear boy. Come on, come on, let's head aboard. Drinks on Arthur. Champagne.
I'm afraid we require all patrons to hand over their guns.
Good time. The tables await.
I'll go find myself a change of clothes.
Okay.
You seem unsure.
Robbing a heavily armed riverboat without a gun tends to bring out the self-doubt in me.
These people are virtually idiots. This is simple stuff. Now have a good time. But don't lose too much money or your wife is going to kill me.
Whatever you say.
Now, where can I get a cocktail?
Hello, mister.
How do you do?
Are you joining us?
Good evening, gentlemen. Arthur Callahan. Sorry I'm late. I had some unfinished business at the bar.
Evening. Desmond Blythe.
Evening.
Not to worry. Welcome to the game, Mr. Callahan. Okay, gentlemen, let's play.
I hope you're a player. Been too many cowards at these tables recently. Nothing less dignified than a man afraid to lose a little money.
Look at this! Chips already stacked up waiting for me. I like this joint already.
We aim to please, sir.
So, how are we all fair?
Some better than others.
If we all fared the same in life now, where would the fun be?
Quiet.
Wait, not Desmond Blythe, the hosiery king. I should have brought my other wallet.
Not my preferred title, but yes, you should have. Okay, sorry, boys, I'm taking it all.
We'll see about that.
To hell with it. Here we go, then.
Hello, my ladies.
Mr. Blythe wins with three queens.
Goodbye, gentlemen.
I guess it's just you and me now, friend.
Yes, it is.
Time to see if you're really the man you seem to think you are.
Likewise, Mr. Blythe.
So, what business are you in, Mr. Callahan?
I'm an oil man, for my sins.
Funny, I haven't heard of you.
Oh, you will. You know, I thought about getting into hosiery, but I just look better in a suit.
I would stick to oil, Mr. Callahan. I don't think you have a future on the stage.
You sound just like my wife.
Sorry to do this to you, but I have no choice. All in.
Call. Interesting.
Pair of cowgirls.
Ship. Ship.
I guess my luck held. Is that you done?
Done?
Bust. Or, you got something else to play with.
Meaning?
Well, I heard... Well, I heard there were some big boys on this boat. Maybe that's not you. No offense.
Sit your hillbilly ass down.
Why?
I got a watch.
Look at you.
An expensive one. Real fine. Swiss. A Reutlinger, no less. It's in the safe upstairs. It's worth more than you.
Okay. I trust you.
Now play.
As you wish.
So, you must know Leviticus Cornwall, big oil man like you.
Of course, we've crossed paths. I was fortunate enough to tour a little operation of his up in New Hanover.
I am 100% all in, Mr. Callahan.
Don't worry, sir. Everyone is the author of his own good fortune.
Well, nothing ventured, nothing gained. Pair of kings.
Very good, but not good enough.
Shit. Uh-oh. Yes, you little beauty.
Hard lines, Mr. Blythe. Mr. Callahan wins with an ace-high diamond flush.
God damn you!
No offense.
None taken.
Well played, sir.
Unlucky, Desmond.
Now, forgive my lack of discretion, but, where might I find this watch?
It's upstairs. Shall we go and have a look?
Why not?
Gentlemen.
Please, cash these out for me.
I started last week.
Good. Sure. Perhaps you could escort us up to the office.
Yes, of course, sir.
Thank you.
Follow me, gentlemen.
Come with me, sir. You're having quite the night.
Yeah, so far.
I cannot believe someone gave a greaser a job.
We live in strange times.
Personally, I wouldn't trust one with a gun, but fear not. I've got my own little lawgiver right here.
Very good.
Next, we'll be hiring Negroes.
Yeah, I know, I know.
I think you're going to like this watch, sir. I saw it earlier, and it really is a handsome piece. Foreign made, but you can't have everything.
Indeed.
Well, here we are. Just give me one second, sir.
Of course, take your time. Don't reach for that gun.
Take his gun, Arthur.
I guess you were right. Only an idiot would give a greaser a gun.
Idiot, huh?
heard that. Quick, clear the safe. Let's get out of here.
Can't believe that asshole had another gun.
The view in here is looking pretty good.
How much is there?
Must be a few thousand, plus the watch.
Nice. Now let's get out of here. Come on. Let's go meet the others.
Sure.
I reckon we've only got a few minutes to get out of here.
If we're lucky.
Was that a gunshot?
It sounded like one. Come on.
And how exactly are we getting out of here?
I ain't too sure. This is what tends to happen when you leave Trelawney in charge of planning. Oh, garnish no meat. Probably involve us dressing up as dancing girls and can-canning off the side. Nice uniform, by the way.
Thanks. I'd give anyone a job these days. Anyway, we shouldn't give ourselves away till we know we need to. Maybe we could still blend into the crowd when it all goes crazy.
Which it surely will. To the bar, senor!
I hope you had fun, sir.
In the time of my life. You boys sure know how to put on a show.
It's wonderful. Ah, look, there's your friend.
My friend is not a no-good cheat, and I beg you to take back the insinuation.
There he is.
Now, don't be a sore loser, friend.
There's something I don't like about the pair of you.
There's plenty I don't like about you, but I have the good manners to keep my mouth shut.
There he is. Shoot that man. Come on, Archer. We gotta get out of here.
Never a dull moment.
Yeah, that's one way of putting it.
So, how much did we get?
A few thousand, I think. Pretty good.
Yes, indeed.
And this watch. Apparently it's worth a bunch. Swiss, a Reutlinger or something?
Nice watch. Yes, it's a Reutlinger, all right.
We'll give it back then. All right, come on, let's get out of here.
Everybody, Rob, read all about it.